cell tin, list 10 cell that's just been doing that for years. Well, we listed 10 and sold 5. November, we listed 10 and sold 5. And it didn't matter that it was fall. That does not affect our market. Listed 10, sold 5. So by January, when the newspaper came out front page going, the sky is falling, I had already been talking to my clients going, hey, something weird's happening. I've been in this for 19 years. I've never seen this before. But the inventory has got to be building up. And then I heard somebody say, you know, if the houses are selling half as fast, then you need to list twice as much. Because we have a very low margin in Kansas City. It's so low. I can't cut back too much more. And although through shift, you kept helping me find more and more ways to cut back more and more and more. So, I mean, we had a great profitable year last year. Probably our best profitable year because we shifted early before we were in trouble. So anyway, with that low margin, you know, we have to make every dollar count.
Yeah. So you realize you had to take more listings.
Yeah, so yeah, that's the point there. I consistently carried 25 to 30 listings, and my listing marketing and everything would just turn them over as fast as I could list them. I could never get away from 30. So I was proud of that because I would sell them as fast as I could get them listed. Well, then it was like, well, shoot, we got to get to 50. So we had a big contest in our office, had the thermometer, and somewhere if we hit a certain point, my team got to shave my legs, and then another point, you know, they got to shave my head. I was doing the old Pat Hyman trick there. But luckily, we just fell short of those numbers about this much, so I got to keep my hair. Everybody knows my hair. I mean, I don't know what I do without my hair. But we set 50 as a goal. And we did actually hit that listing goal, and we had a big party. It was like a day after the goal. It's like I would come into the office, Gary, I'd be like, 2 listings, and they go, sold 1. It's like, crap, I'm at 49, you know? And I remember Sunday night, the night before, I was listing 2 houses, and I came in and they sold 1, and I got to 51, you know? And so we had a big party and all that stuff. But it was from that point forward, you know, we have never gone back below 60. I mean, we hit the 60 mark. Now we just bounce around 60, 65, 70, and I can't even get below that. So, and it's good because
you've discovered you have to have that many in order to hit the minimum numbers you have to get.
Exactly. That's minimum. I mean, that's for us to be able to pay our bills, keep the lights on, drive a car that starts every day.
Yeah. Barbara, any experiences like that when the markets begin to shift?
Well, especially over this last year, as we've had so many first-time home buyers in the market, what we saw in our particular market was that kind of mid-range and our high-end listings just quit selling. You know, so number one, we had to have more listings because our average price went down by $100,000. So, and it's not to say that the Dallas market went down by a third. That's to say what was selling went down by a third. So that meant that just to keep the same inventory or the same dollar volume coming in, we had to increase, you know, our production. So that's what we've been doing.
And what are you doing to do that?
Well, we've got a couple of things that we do. Number one, we are very systematized at following up with every single showing that goes through our homes. Well, let me back up a minute. First of all, we stage every single one of our listings. We pay to have it staged.
Okay.
So, well, I feel like, you know, you've got 3 things that are going to sell a home, and the 3 things that people take into consideration is going to be price, it's going to be condition, and it's going to be location. Well, we can't change the location, so we're stuck with that one. We can influence the price, and we can definitely have a big impact on what the condition of the property looks like. So, I feel like if I'm going to give them the best chance of success, then I want it to look as good as